Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of Creating Process, and today we are here again to create under a very unique design. If you look at this logo, it has got a very complex structure, but the way it has been presented is very simple. It has got a basic shape of heart where in the middle it has got a very complex structure where surface is revolving around an invisible cylinder where the base is thick and on the top it has got narrowed. So to design this logo, we'll use the rectangle tool to create out this basic shape of heart. Then with the help of pen tool and line segment tool, we'll create out these each pieces, and with the help of shape builder tool, we'll separate out the individual shapes. Then we'll fill up the gradient color and add up this glossy effect and then the text. So let's begin the tutorial. So we'll start out with the rectangle tool. I'll select the rectangle tool and left click my mouse button. Here we'll give the width around 150 and the height around 110 and click OK. And our rectangle is created. Now I'll put this around here, and what I'll do is I'll play with the measurements. So with the Control R, I'll bring out the ruler key and I'll just bring out this and place the zero around here. Now what I'll do is I'll add some anchor points here. So with the help of pen tool, I'll create an anchor point one around here, and with the direct selection tool, I'll just select this and shift this to around, let's say it's minus 75. Okay, that's fine. So I have given some height of 75, minus 75. Now once I have created that, I'll just exchange the color and remove the fill color so that I can get that shape. So you can see we have got that nice shape, basic shape of heart. Next thing we need to do is we need to create out this shape. So we'll be creating out these shapes using the line segment tool first. So I'll select the line segment tool and draw out one from here, finishing at around here. So we'll be creating out the shapes from here, the other one around here, and from one tool here, one around from here, giving some space and closer to this, under from here and around here, one from here, giving some height and finishing at here. Now once I've get that, I'll do some adjustments here. If you see the logo, we have to do a little adjustment, like we have to maintain the thickness here. So I'll just play around with this here and this one. Okay, good. This one we have to push it up a little bit, I think. So just play around with these vertices, maintaining the shape here. I think this is good. This one we need to get a little bit, push it down here, around here. Okay, that's fine. Then we'll look at this. Okay, this thickness, we have to just push this a little bit up. And this one, I'll just push this a little bit up one more. And this one, thickness, good. This one, I have to increase the thickness a little bit here. So once I have done all of these, next thing is I'll do this curve effect. So to draw that curve effect, I'll use these anchor point tool and make the curve. So I'll just select this and okay, like this. Just do that in the same way from here also, just maintain the flow. In the same way, select this and do this like this and maintain the flow from here also like this. And we need to do some adjustment here. Just extend this a little bit more higher. In the same way, select this, extend this a little bit more higher on the top and maintain the flow from here like that. So we'll do all this. Select this, extend this to top like that, giving a nice curve here. In the same way, maintain the flow from here also. So we'll do this for this also. I'll just go here and select this piece. Okay. And selecting the anchor point, we'll just make this more curve like that, maintaining the flow, this one, and this one, finishing, giving a nice touch here. In the same way, select this one also, and with the anchor point tool, we'll just give this little flow like that, and here also, we'll just maintain the flow. And after that, once we have achieved everything, we need to look at it very carefully so that we haven't made any mistake, like we have to maintain the flow like. After this, with the direct selection tool, I'll do the adjustment. So for the finishing part, I'll just select this and give it more turn, twist, and maintaining the flow like that. Selecting this one, we need to give a little more higher. So select this, give it some higher tone. This one, just extend it a little bit more. This one, we need to do some reduce at this. Okay, like that. So once you have grabbed everything, next thing is I'll use the shape builder tool, and what I'll do is I'll select everything first, and with the shape builder tool just fill this up with certain colors. So I'll just change the color to something like blue and just select this, 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 and this. So you can see that this is now one piece. I'll just select these pieces first, select this, 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 and this, and I'll place it aside and delete these unnecessary portions. And once I've got that, I'll just bring this here and I'll remove the stroke color from here, and we have got a plain nice color. Now next thing we need to do is we need to create this inner surface, and to create that we'll use the pen tool and draw out these shapes. So I'll just click here, giving a touch here, giving a nice curve here, give it a cut here, and give it some different color so that we can distinguish them, like dark tone, that would be good. And here, giving the finishing curve like that, break there and finish it. In the same way, we'll draw a few more. So we'll draw out for this from here till here, giving it a nice curve, maintaining the flow. This one, finish it. This one, giving a cut. This one, make a curve like that, maintaining the flow, finish it, and done. In the same way, from here also, last piece till here, giving it a curve, nice curve, like give it a little more lesser, and this one around here, and finish it around here like that, and cut, place. And what I'll do is I'll just arrange this to the back side. So with a shift press, I'll select these three, and with the control and open square bracket, I'll just bring this down. So we have created that shape. Next thing is we have to create these individual shapes, this one. So I'll just duplicate this, control C, control F, and what I'll do is I'll draw out with a pen tool, I'll draw out some surfaces from here, giving it a cut around here like that, and after that just finish it up here. And I'll just give this little different color so that you can see it out like that. And what I'll do is I'll select this, this, and with the Pathfinder tool here, I'll just subtract this out, and we are left with this. In the same way, I'll duplicate this, control C, control F, and I'll draw out first this piece. So with the pen tool, I'll just draw out from here, one, finishing it here, and I'll just complete this, and selecting this and this, subtract it out. In the same way, duplicate this one more, control C, control F, and with a pen tool again, draw out one more, giving it a nice curve around here like that. This, 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 finish it up like that, and after that select this piece, and separate it out. So we have got this, 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 so everything is now there. We are left with this one. We have to create that. So I'll duplicate this, control C, control F, and I'll just slide this down one more like that. Scale this up a little bit, like to C, and after that what I'll do is with the direct selection tool, I'll just bring this around here to this point so that we can get that curve, and I'll just play with the handle like that. Now I'll do is I'll select this, this, and subtract it out, and we are left with this piece. So this, 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 everything is done. Now let's fill it up with the gradient color. Select this with the eye picker, select this color with the shift and alt pressed. In the same way, select this, V, I, select the color, not this one, this one. But we have to select this first. Select this one with the eye picker, select this color. Select this piece with the eye picker, select this color. V selection, I select this color. Now we'll give the gloss effect. So I'll select this piece with the eye picker. I have given some this, but this is a white color. You can see it's a white color, but I have reduced the opacity to 50%, and over here under here you can see in transparency I have given overlay. So you have to give that and you will get that nice effect. In the same way, I select this and this with the eye picker, select this color, and you'll get that nice effect here, nice tone. I'll reduce, or you can increase this or let me check, we can increase it to 60. Let's check it out, this one. And you got that nice shade here. Select this with the art picker, or select this color. You can change the transparency mode here. We can just check it out what color will be suitable for here. So I'll just check it out. Okay, let's increase the opacity to 100 first, and let's play around with the color transparency. So let's see. Okay, this one, that's good. But if you look at this, it has got some dark color, and they basically it's the gradient color. So I can just choose it from here with the RPG. I'll just select this and apply to this. And now let's play with the gradient tool. I'll select this. This is the gradient tool. Just make this in the angle. Select this. G for gradient. Just make sure they are in the perfect angle. Select this. G. This is good. Select this. G. This is also good. Now last thing we're left with here is this one. You can see we have to give this nice curve here. So what I'll do is I'll select this, and with the anchor point tool, just click and drag and shift press, you will drag it out like that. In the same way from here also, with a shift press, I'll just drag it out like that, and you have got that nice curve. And if you want to maintain more, what we can do is we can add some anchor point here. So I'll use the pen tool and draw the anchor point around in the middle, and I'll just push this down, selecting this a little bit, and you got that nice curve here like that. And last thing, select this with the eye picker, select this color, V, select this eye picker, select this dark brown color, V, select this with the eye picker, select this dark blue color, and G for gradient. Just make sure they are in the perfect angle. G, gradient, make sure like that. V for selection, G for gradient from here till there, and done. Let's type out the text for final step. I'll use the font T. The font which I have used is Nexalite. I'll just select this out and EX Nexalite, and I'll draw it out like harmony, HRMONY harmony. And I think it's black. I'll just change the color to white, and let's scale it up to around, let's check it out. Okay, let's check it out. Okay, I have given around 30 like that, and I'll place this around here. And under character, I'll just increase the distance between each alphabet to around 160, maybe 170, and reduce the fonts to, let's say, around 28, and increase the font distance to around 180. Or maybe a little bit more. Just increase it with the scroll key. You can just control D, and we have done it. So finally, we have created out this very unique design, which is very complex, but the way it has been presented is very simple due to the basic shape which we have used, that is heart. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more advanced designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.